AITA for not quitting my job over colleague's crush? I am not op. Original post by you, Prudent Coat 8988 in our Amethyus hole. Trigger warning. Emotional abuse. Less than. And NBSP. AITA for not quitting my job over colleague's crush? The 19th of August 2021. I, 32, F. Live with my partner, 44 per meter, and work in research. My primary colleague, 30 per meter, and I have worked together for 2 years on a major project involving significant intellectual and labor contributions from us both. The project is expected to span at least another 2 years, and is vital to both of our careers. Not long ago, my colleague confessed to me that he is, and has been, infatuated or in love with me for pretty much the duration. It took place via a long email that was written after an evening of drinking. This was totally unexpected. In retrospect, there may have been some signs, but nothing that wouldn't just as easily be accounted for by a considerate personality. Shortly after this confession, I came to my husband with the issue. I wanted to get his advice about the situation, and showed him the drafts which I'd composed to organize my thoughts on the matter. They stated unequivocally that I'm not interested in a romantic relationship, and hope these feelings won't complicate our work together. I was again surprised at my husband's reaction. He seemed offended to think I must have invited my colleague's affections, and that I should immediately quit my job, as in, put in notice tomorrow. I was so taken aback, my immediate reaction was to laugh, snort at this suggestion, which was probably a mistake. That would be utterly disastrous for my career, and isn't an option I'm willing to consider. I'd greatly prefer the entire scenario had never happened, as a difficult and lengthy project hangs in the balance. But I have no real concern at this point about my colleague forcing the issue or letting it compromise our work. It seemed like an intoxicated, getting my feelings off my chest. I'll need to put a lot of thought and caution into how I proceed with the work dynamic. But abandoning our project isn't even on the table. About a week has passed. My husband has been alternating between irate and the silent treatment, and suggested several times that I should move out of the house to be with my new spouse. Today I swung by the house on my lunch break and found the locks changed and my luggage on the patio. I have been blocked on his work number and cell. Obviously, he cannot possibly intend for me to really move out, and is just pulling what I absolutely believe to be an asshole-ish power sulk, but seeing how seriously he's taking this has my doubts up. Maybe I was ultimately too uncompromising when I refused to even entertain quitting my job for the sake of conversation and his feelings, and to shut the idea down so abruptly. AITA? Update. Hubby called me. Long story short, he's been extremely anxious each day when I leave for work, and buckled from that pressure today. I'm welcome back home once I've quit my job, which is obviously still unacceptable. I am considering taking a week of accrued paid leave, which will hopefully result in an adult conversation with husband, as well as coming to a decision about how to best handle colleague. That failing, I'm hearing the word lawyer loud and clear throughout these comments. I'm grateful for all of the support and perspective. Update 2. I ended up calling my sister, 38, F. Something I avoided initially because I didn't want to stir the pot by involving family members who are already disliked by husband. I'm currently with her and cousin, 35 per meter, who are both supportive. Our plan is to call a locksmith tomorrow to regain access to the property. Husband can ruminate with friends or at a hotel for the present. For cousin to collect some important things of mine from the house, and for me to stay with my sister for a few days while I take a hard look at my situation and options. I'm not set on divorce at this point, but I definitely need to reassert some very basic boundaries before exploring further discussion. with husband. Thank you, strangers on Reddit, for helping me emerge from the emotional haze with some clarity. Update. Enormous thanks for all of the private messages after the comments were locked. I'm a little overwhelmed with life in general right now, so I haven't replied to everyone, but I wanted to update and let it be known that I'm safe and well. My husband tried to bar my cousin from entering the family home to retrieve my things, which escalated to a physical confrontation. The police arrived and both husband and cousin were made to leave the premises. My sister and I changed the locks the next day to secure the house. And I'm staying with family for a little while I plan my next move, which will in all likelihood be a divorce. Thanks again to all who've shared feedback and concern. And NBSP. Reminder, I am not the original poster. Prudent, coat 8988 oxygen monophosphide 1 year. A go house is actually in my name. Inherited from my dad before I married. The luggage he packed contained only some random things. A couple of suits. Miscellaneous items from my nightstand. This makes me believe he's just chucking an outsized tantrum instead of expecting me to actually vacate, but you've brought up some good points. It's not even his house. What an insecure little weasel. Oh, she's welcome back to her own house as soon as she quits. Oh, how generous. S. What a insecure dirtbag of a husband. Hope Oop just ditches the whole man. Also, he dislikes several of her family members? In the context of his behavior, this doesn't sound right at all. That took a sharp left turn. If the husband is worried about her work colleague, wouldn't throwing her out of her house potentially push her towards someone else? I would take odds that he is cheating, or at least involved in some level of emotional affair. And this reaction is 100% his guilty conscience screaming. A solid and secure spouse would say, "Geez, can't blame the guy. You are pretty great." And then help tactfully navigate this career minefield. Welp, give it a couple years and coworker might have a chance. She handled this in a mature and communicative way and he decides to completely torpedo his marriage? I hope the divorce goes well for her, because this man is not worth staying with. I thought this was going to be an HR nightmare story, but wowee. Colleague is probably sitting back with popcorn watching husband dig his own marital grave. Surprise, surprise, another dude on here that's 12 years older than his partner turns out to be a manipulative boss. S. Really revolting reaction from the husband. I can see why OOP's family didn't like him. Ridiculous level of completely unfounded jealousy. I hope she is happier without him. Well, that took a sharp turn or two. Oop. My coworker just sent me a sexually harassing email that's totally inappropriate. Quote, OOP's husband. You were asking for it. You hussy. Quote. Better than even odds the husband is cheating. Dudes don't kick a woman out for the kinds of reasons he's saying unless he's got a girl on the side. He's just trying to justify it. Seriously thinking at least one of these updates will be, found out my husband was actually having an affair and he wanted to leave but wanted it to be my fault so he didn't have to split assets accrued during the marriage. Way to give green light for the coworker guy to swoop in. OP's husband is amazing. Family members who are already disliked by husband and there it is. God damn, OP's husband is exuding big, I'm punchable, energy. After reading that, my first thought was, this dirtbag husband is probably cheating already. We'll see if I am proven right. If there's one thing I've learned from talking to the women I've worked with, It's that if they left every job where someone hit on them or acted inappropriately, there'd be no working women in a majority of the world. Psycho husband and creepy coworker. In one of the comments, she mentions that the house is in her name. That really blew my mind. The dude kicked her out of her own home. I don't think there's ever any coming back from, my life partner locked me out of my own home. Without warning or remorse. That's wrecking ball to the foundation levels of betrayal of trust. If you can't feel safe in your own home, how can you life comfortably?
If you enjoyed this video, please check out our playlists full of similar content. Epic Eracast is like doom scrolling for your ears. Please like, share, and subscribe.